Tell us your secret.
Again. Secret of longevity?
Yes.
Okay. Eat properly, number one. Don't eat and go to bed right away. And don't eat after 7 o'clock at night.
Uh-oh. Wow.
That's it?
That's all I can think of right now. Let's see now. What else? And exercise. Always exercise.
Tell us about your routine.
Well, routines in the morning from a.m. I usually get up and have a light breakfast, which would be mostly oatmeal, coffee, and sometimes scrambling a couple of eggs. Mm-hmm. And toast, of course. And then that's my breakfast, more or less. Sometimes I cheat a little bit. And then during the midday, I just do my regular chores around the house. Take a walk sometime up the block to see, you know, come back in the house. And do the chores in the house, which is always something to do. Please. I hate to even mention it. So, that's about it.
Now, Mr. Outlaw, you're 100 years old.
Right.
Do you still drive?
Oh, yes, I drive. I don't drive at night, but I drive during the day when I go, like shopping, you know. But I can drive at night, but the lights bother me.
Headlights. Oh, but, yes, oncoming headlights.
My car is a regular car, and headlights on the, what they call it, the SUVs?
Yeah.
The up high, and they shine right in my windshield.
I have that problem too.
I don't have no place to go at night anyway. so it really doesn't matter.
So it works out.
It works out fine.
Yes.
And My car runs good. My car's a 60, 62.
Wow.
62 Ford. Wow. I bought it new. It's only got about 60,000 miles on it. 60,000.
That's not so much.
And it's very low. Because I'm a driver locally.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I go shopping to the supermarket. Otherwise, long distance driving, no drive. Sometimes I go Rite Aid, not mm-hmm. Rite Aid, but Key Food.
Oh, up in Rochdale?
Right here. Sometimes I go out to Green Acres, you mm-hmm. know. Place out there. Wow. And I have the lady, she's going with me, mm-hmm. my home care attendant.
I'd like to know, do you have any special soap treatment?
Soap?
Facial treatment, body treatment?
No, I buy
regular soap.
Regular soap.
What kind? Ivory, Dove?
Skin
Anything is on sale.
No special skin treatment?
No, nothing like that. But I could mention, I used to use, some people pronounce it oxygen soap.
Octagon.
That's strong.
That's
the peel your skin off. Exactly. That's brown soap.
Right.
Brown.
But it's not as strong as it used to be.
No.
Oh, probably not.
No, I haven't used it recently. Maybe it's been 6 or 7 months. But I like to keep it in the house, particularly upstairs. Mm-hmm. If I wash my hands, mm-hmm. I have confidence in the soap for some reason. So I use it to wash my hands, and sometimes I show my face with it.
Yeah.
But it's good. Once the skin gets adjusted to it, it'll accept
your
face.
True.
Right.
But
if you don't get a rash from the strength of it.
Right, but I like it. I like it. Okay. Yes, Miss Andy, what's next?
So, 100 years ago, or maybe not 100, let's say 90 years ago.
That was 10 years ago, yeah.
You remember, like, sharecropping and all that stuff?
Oh, yes. Yeah. I wasn't, my parents, my father was, actually I was there. Oh, yes. Sharecropping is the thing in the South, like, in my generation, my early generation age, and my parents' generation, it's the only job they had,
right.
Is sharecropping. Some people, you probably heard about it, some people had big sawmills going around.
No.
Now, sawmills is like, like your mother saying that. No kidding, yeah. So sawmills is a place where people do day's work, they go in the woods and cut down manure.
Right.
They didn't have electric saw that people, manually cut down the pine tree, mm-hmm. fall down, take it, saw and chop it up, take it to the sawmill. That's where your lumber comes out. But right. that was the only job that was most around in the farming area.
Hmm. Yeah, so how did you get paid for that?
Well, I remember, I didn't work with my father. I remember my father working. He get paid about $1.50 a day.
Jesus.
Because he used to talk about it. Mm. For that kind of labor. Yeah. This was 1930. I didn't take my
year. If you could manage.
This is 1930.
To live.
Wow.
Like 1931, 32. What is that?
I said, they worked hard for that $1.50.
Oh, yes.
All day.
1930, in the 30s and the late 20s. Yeah. I remember.
Mm.
Very well. Because my father he never complained.
And some sharecroppers, after the black people would get their crops in,
mm-hmm.
the owners would run them off the plantation. And they, this way they don't have to share.
Take everything.
They don't have to share the money with them.
Right. Then you got to find
the clan some. Would come along and burn them out, run them out, whatever.
Then you have to find some other place to stay.
That's what my grandfather told us.
Yeah. Well, that was mostly like in Georgia, Alabama, those tough states.
Yeah.
But in North Carolina, we was around the border of Virginia. Yeah. And North Carolina wasn't too bad.
No, South Carolina was the bad.
Yeah.
South Carolina was the rough.
Yeah, it wasn't too bad.
When did you come to New York?
When I come to New York in 1939.
Oh.
Matter of fact, yeah, because I was about 20 years old over there. Because I was born in 1919.
I think that would have, Mama, if she lived this long, she was born in 1919.
Right, I remember. Yeah. Same age. Thank you. 1919.
Oh, well.
Oh, all right.
So you came from North Carolina straight to New York?
Straight to New York. When it cost $10, $10 from North Carolina to New York, on the train. We get a bus from North Carolina to Virginia.
Well, guess what? I thought I
had to go. And then we got a bus.
And fell down.
To the ferry. Mm-hmm. No. That's right. We got up and get a ferry and got across. Now they have a bridge. From Norfolk.
It fell all the way back.
Yeah, so they had a ferry.
Chesapeake Bridge.
Oh, yeah.
I know. Hi.
Okay.
Oh, you know, I didn't read this record.
Yeah, we got another stop to make.
Oh.
Yeah.
So you enjoy.
I thought
nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Take care of yourselves.
All right.
I thought the day was going to be all my day.
Yeah, it's your day.
Is that it? What's that?
Yeah.
Thanks for coming by. Hey, Robert, you okay?
Yes.
Yeah, Robert.
Yes, Robert.